Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to The Lead. I'm Jake Tapper. We're going to begin with the politics lead. Welcome to Obama Tapped My Phone Island. Population? President Trump. The White House saying the president has no regrets about his fact-free claim that then-President Obama tapped his phone last year, even though just about everyone else in the city in the know or with the power to investigate the claim says it's not true or that they've seen nothing that can support the accusation. That includes Republican leaders on the Hill. That includes officials at the White House. And it also includes FBI Director Comey, who in his first appearance since President Trump's tweets over the weekend did not address the claim at all. Even the president's own press secretary, when pressed, said that the matter is above his pay grade. And today we learned that President Obama, no stranger to Donald Trump's needling, might need another kitesurfing getaway after seeing the president's tweet storm. CNN's Sarah Murray is live for us at the White House. And Sarah, the White House says the president would request the investigation from lawmakers, but theoretically, he's the one sitting on this non-existent evidence.
It's a little bit of a conundrum over here today, Jake. And White House Press Secretary Sean Spicer went even further today, saying that there's no reason to believe the president is the subject of a counterintelligence probe, but still not offering any proof as to why the president would suggest that he had been wiretapped by former President Barack Obama.
It's been 4 days since President Trump's shocking claim that President Obama spied on him. And while there's still no evidence from the White House, today senators say they want proof.
The president has asked Congress to look into whether or not his campaign was wiretapped by the Obama administration. I will take up that challenge.
In a Saturday morning tweet storm, Trump alleged that Obama ordered a wiretap on Trump Tower, the home of then-candidate Trump and the location of his campaign headquarters. Today, Republican Senator Lindsey Graham and Democratic Senator Sheldon Whitehouse penned a letter to the Justice Department and the FBI, asking for copies of warrant applications or court orders related to Trump wiretaps. They wrote, "We would take any abuse of wiretapping authorities for political purposes very seriously. We would be equally alarmed to learn that a court found enough evidence of criminal activity or contact with a foreign power to legally authorize a wiretap of President Trump, the Trump campaign, or Trump Tower." Trump's claim inspiring other senators to ask for more details.
As far as the information from the president, I would like him to turn over any evidence that he has supporting his tweet from this weekend about surveillance. I think that would be helpful to our investigation.
The seemingly unfounded wiretapping allegation casting a shadow over Trump's other ambitions. At a health care markup today, one Democrat called out his GOP colleagues for their silence on Trump's claims.
You would think we were asking someone to comment on whether or not President Obama was a criminal who wiretapped President Trump at Trump Tower, because they've been silent on that. Indeed, every outrageous statement, every crazy tweet, they are silent on that.
As for the FBI director, sources tell CNN that James Comey is incredulous about Trump's Twitter allegations. At a cybersecurity conference today, Comey wouldn't address the issue head on, but made it clear he plans to serve out his term.
You're stuck with me for about another 6.5 years.
Meanwhile, the subject of these allegations, former President Obama, denied through a spokesman ever ordering surveillance of a U.S. citizen. Sources say Obama was, quote, irked and exasperated and in a state of disbelief about Trump's wiretapping claims.
Now, President Trump may have lobbed this wiretapping allegation to try to move the conversation away from Russia, but that's not exactly what's happening. There are a number of senators who have made or are about to make the trek out to CIA headquarters. They want to view the raw intelligence about Russia attempting to meddle in the U.S. election and find out for themselves whether they see any evidence of collusion between former Trump advisors, current Trump campaign advisors, and some